Hello and welcome to the lesson on implementing security in the OutSystems platform. Now, security is actually a very broad and complex field, and we're going to focus on one specific thing. But just so you have an idea, the OutSystems platform already supports things like HTTP access and integrated authentication to your screens or web services. It has mechanics to prevent code injection into your code and SQL statements. It allows you to select which applications are deployed on which individual machines on your factory. And as we will see in a different lesson, it also allows you to implement exception handling where you can trap certain errors, including security. One thing that it can't do automatically for you, however, is decide what level of access each user has to the several areas of your application. So when you're designing access control, you need to be able to decide who can do what, access screens, trigger actions, etc. in your applications. This needs to be obviously done and implemented by yourself. Now there's two sides to controlling access. One of them is authentication and the other one is authorization. Authentication is the process of identifying who is trying to access your application, and you need to do so by validating the credentials of the user. Once a user is authenticated, you can then grant him access, authorize him to do certain things. So at discrete points, you need to validate if the authenticated user is authorized to carry out that action. The standard way to provision users in the OutSystems platform is through the built-in users application. At its most simple, you create a user and you specify his username, password, and name. Once the user is known in your system, you can then start to authorize certain functionalities. It's very likely that you'll find that several users have the same level of access. So therefore, the OutSystems platform also provides the concept of groups. A group simply allows you to authorize a set of users with the same level of access. You now know how you can create users and groups to authenticate them. Once they exist in the system, the act of authorizing is done via the application roles. Now, every single user in an OutSystems application always has the anonymous role. And as soon as he or she logs in, he's granted the registered system role. Though useful, the registered role is, however, too broad. It is important for you to be able to specify at application level certain roles so that you can enable certain behaviors. You do so by creating them inside the logic tab of your model. Now, each role has its own check, grant, and revoke actions. And these actions exist as well in the registered role. Once roles exist in your module and it's published, these become available in the user's application. So you're able to statically and via backoffice authorize users to do certain things, to have certain roles. In your code, these roles can be checked in the screens and actions. The simplest way to enforce a certain role in a screen is using the properties of the screen, as you can see in the screenshot. In this particular example, if an anonymous user tries to navigate to my screen, he will be pushed to the login screen because a security exception will have been thrown. You won't need to write any other code other than ticking these role checkboxes. Now, in the code, you will want to use the check role function for the role that you want to validate. And common places that you want to do so are in an if widget, and therefore you can have two sections of the screen that will appear to someone that has the role or not, and in your code using an if statement, where you can decide if execution should take one path or the other depending on the user having the role or not. So, a very quick recap, you have two built-in roles, anonymous that everyone has, and registered that everyone that is logged in has. Then you can create custom roles inside of your modules. And just so you know, these roles can actually be made public so they can be used and checked on a different module. While you can authorize users using the user's application, It's also possible to authorize a user in runtime using the grant role action or remove the role using the revoke role. In runtime as well, you can enforce that the user has a certain role by using the roles properties in the screen or programmatically by calling the check role for your role. As a closing note, it's important to mention that when you create a custom role, you can decide if it is to be persistent or not. If you set its is persistent property to yes, it means that the role is stored in the database and will be persisted across multiple sessions. And this is the default value. And that's it for implementing security in an OutSystems platform. See ya!